Thank you for joining me on my masterclass. Now, today we're talking about how you can legally get dollars for your Naira in Nigeria. How you can legally convert your Naira to dollars in Nigeria. Now, the reason why, the background behind this video is that yesterday I did a video forecasted that the Naira is going to crash. It's probably going to hit something like 700 Naira to $1 in the year 2022 that we're entering in a few hours. And, you know, like I gave empirical evidence as to why this is the case. Right now, Nigeria's debt service to revenue ratio is about 98%. This is from the African Development Bank and the World Bank. It's 98%. But Fitch Rating is the number one ratings agency in the whole world. So you got Fitch, and then you got Standard & Poor's, and you got KPMG. So at the top is Fitch. And Fitch has said that, you know, with the new 12 trillion Naira loan that General Muhammadu Buhari wants to take in 2022. Now, don't forget that this man met total loan that Nigeria owed of about 11.7 trillion, let's just say 12 trillion in 2015. Right now, we are owing something like 40 trillion Naira. And then he said that he wants to borrow an additional 12 trillion in the coming year that we're going to enter in a few hours. So it's going to bring our total debt to between 50 to 52 trillion. So Fitch is forecasting that our debt service to revenue ratio is going to be 395%. You know, so what that means is that we're not going to be making enough money to pay our debts. We're not going to be making enough money to service our debts. So you got to think about that. So it's going to have an effect on our currency, because, you know, our currency is a floating currency. It's not a fixed currency. It's not pegged to any currency in the world. So it's a fixed currency. So when you have a floating currency, it's governed by the laws of demand and supply, and the laws of demand and supply are heavily, very, very heavily in favor of the dollar. You know, in the last 10 years, Nigerians spent $28 billion, you know, on health tourism. And the number one health tourist in Nigeria is, of course, the president of Nigeria, General Muhammadu Buhari. So Nigeria has also spent about $10 billion on foreign education, $10 billion of foreign education, with about between $800 to $1 billion of that going to Ghana, where there are about anywhere of up to 70,000 Nigerian students. You know, so if you look at the fuel subsidy regime, it's increased from 360 billion under former President Jonathan to about 1.6 trillion today. You know, so it's so you see, that's a lot of money that should be circulating in Nigeria is going out. So it doesn't take a prophet to know that the Naira is going to crash. The Naira is going to crash to probably about 700 Naira to $1. Now, Aliko Dangote said sometime in the past that he sees Naira going to 1,000 Naira to $1. Yes, I think eventually it might come to that, but I like to give a yearly forecast. And so with what I'm seeing, I think it's going to hit around 700 Naira to $1. So people watched my videos yesterday and they saw the solution I gave. I gave three solutions. I said, you should not save your money in Naira, and you should not save your money in real estate, because the value of the Naira is affecting the price of real estate in Nigeria. I give an example of myself. I sold my house in Abuja, and then my sister was telling me, oh no, don't sell it. You know how family are like. Don't sell it, don't sell it. I sold the house, and then after 6 months, you know, what I sold the house for, I could have used half of that money to buy that house again. That's how much the house had fallen in value. So I gave three solutions. I said, change your money to dollars, buy gold, or buy US shares. And yet I give a site where you can buy US shares. I said you can buy US shares on a site called Bamboo. I'm not doing this because I'm unpatriotic. I want to do this because I want to help Nigerians protect their wealth, because I hate poverty, and I don't see any reason why Nigerians should become poor because they have an irresponsible, profligate government that is just squandering their resources. And that's why I'm doing this. Well, anyway, after watching that video, oh my gosh, so many people, you know, reached back to me via email, you can go and look at the video. You know, the comment section of that video is packed full of comments, and then they came to my verified social media profiles asking me, how can we get dollars? How can we get gold? How can we get dollars? So maybe tomorrow I'll talk about how you can get gold. So today, because the overwhelming number of feedback was, how can we get dollars? Now, there are three ways you can get dollars in Nigeria. There are just three ways you can get dollars. You can get dollars directly from the commercial banks that the Central Bank of Nigeria sells dollars to. And so when you're getting them, it's the rates are going to vary. It's going to be from anywhere from 414 naira to 483 naira, or from 414 naira to 533 naira. So the rates are going to vary, you know. But the issue with that is that to get that, you have to be maybe in the cabal of the Buhari administration. That's the easiest way. Or maybe you have to know somebody in the Central Bank of Nigeria, and then you do something that is not quite kosher. Or, and this is the only legal way to do it, you have to be a traveler, you apply for your basic travel allowance, meaning that you have to have a visa, then you have to have bought a ticket. You have to, because they're going to want to see a confirmed ticket, not a ticket you can cancel, a confirmed ticket. And then when you show them, then they put you on a queue. You may get it, you may not get it, you know, but that's just how, that's the legal way to get it, the first legal way. Then another way you can do it, you know, you can do it through peer-to-peer exchanges. So you have people who are coming into the country, you know, and then who they have pounds, they've got dollars, and then they want to change. And then that's called peer-to-peer, person-to-person. You can do it through that. Now, a third way, because most people who sent me feedback, they were under the illusion that the federal government of Nigeria had banned Bureau de Change, so they couldn't go to Bureau de Change. You know, and then, you know, like, I was actually misled by them until I did some research, you know. I did some research. I actually sent my staff in Nigeria, I said, go to a Bureau de Change, go to Zone 4 in Abuja, where you have a number of Bureau de Change, and then and verify from them, find out, have your licenses been seized? You know, have you guys been run out of business? Can Nigerians no longer patronize you? And, you know, we got the feedback that, no, nothing like that. What happened is that on July 29th, 2021, on July 29th of this year, the Central Bank of Nigeria, they initiated a policy whereby they said, henceforth, they will no longer sell Forex to Bureau de Change. So, before that, what used to happen was that they would sell Forex to Bureau de Change, and then so to try to make it easier for Nigerians and for small and medium scale enterprises to get dollars, you know. So nobody, because, you know, like, there's some kind of like bottleneck at the central bank and even in commercial banks. So Bureau de Change were filling that void, that vacuum. But then on July 29th, 2021, maybe because like the Naira, the value of the Naira was crashing fast and they were seeking scapegoats, the central bank governor said, henceforth, they're not going to sell to Bureau de Change. So they stopped. But they did not revoke the licenses of the Bureau de Change, and they did not stop them from operating. So basically what it meant is that however you can find dollars legally as a Bureau de Change, if you can find dollars, if you can find pounds, if you can find euros, if you can find yuans and yens, you can sell. But it's just that the federal government through the Central Bank of Nigeria is not going to be selling to you. That's what happened. So these guys have found ingenious ways to get dollars. Now, don't ask me how. They told me it's legal, you know, and then their operating license, they still have their licenses, so by they can legally sell dollars to you. So you can still go to the Bureau de Change and sell your Naira and buy dollars. You can still go to Bureau de Change all over Nigeria and exchange your Naira for dollars. As a matter of fact, you know, I'm gonna pause here and then you're gonna see my staff. My staff actually went to Zone 4, to a group of Bureau de Change to confirm this. Watch this video.
Today is 31st of December 2021. And I'm here on behalf of Pastor Renaud Mokri to verify that Bureau de Change are still in operation. Yeah. They are still fully in operation. You see that today is 31st December 2021, Friday. And you see they are fully in operation. You can see it. Zone 4.
So that's the easiest way for you to get dollars, you know, it's going through a borrowed exchange, you know, like it's just by far the easiest way. Now, obviously, the rates are not going to be the same. With borrowed exchange, you're looking at anywhere from between 555 to 575, depending on what part of the country that you're in. But if you say to yourself, no, it's too high, I'm not going to change my, look, the Naira is going to crash. So by the time it gets to 700, you're holding Naira and then you're going to be feeling bad. You know, you might say to yourself, okay, I'm going to get dollars from the bank. If you're going to get dollars from the bank, what are you going to do? You're going to invest money. First of all, you need a visa. Maybe to the United Kingdom, to Turkey, to the United States, you know, South Africa. You need a visa. Then you have to go and buy a ticket. So maybe a ticket will set you back somewhere between $800 to $2,000. And then you produce that. And then at the end of the day, it's not even 100% guaranteed that you get it because a lot of people don't get it. You know, many get it, some don't get it. So it's just, you know, it just makes it easier for you to get your dollars through borrowed exchange. Yes, the prices, you know, are a bit steep compared to commercial banks. You know, I think with the commercial bank you can get it anywhere from 414, which is almost impossible, to 533, which is more likely. But then you're going to get it with the borrowed exchanges for about from 555 to 575. You know, it's worth it. Now, that is not the only way. Another way that you can do, and then this is because of the non-sale of dollars to broad exchange, you're going to find out that it's mostly broad exchanges in places like Abuja, Kaduna, Lagos, Port Harcourt, maybe Enugu, that would have forex to sell. A lot of them have shut down. Now, so another alternative, if you live close to the border, if you live, say, maybe like in close to the Badagry area, close to the Idiroko area in Ogun State, or if you live close to Jibia in Katsina State, or, you know, if you're in the Jega area of Kebbi State, you know, just around the border, what you can do, because in countries like Benin Republic and Togo, a lot of these guys have moved there for greener pastures. A lot of northerners who sell forex, they move there for greener pasture. And then in those countries, you know, they have a very relaxed forex regime because their currency is pegged, not like Nigeria that has a floating currency. So their currency is pegged. So you can change currency legally at hotels, at borrowed exchanges, at banks. So you can take, and then you still have that limit. You are allowed to take as much as $10,000, no more than $10,000 or the equivalent. So you're allowed to take the equivalent of that out of the country to those countries because, and then you can change them there. But here's the thing, it's fraught with risk. You're traveling with a large sum of money, you know, that you could be robbed, you could be, you know, you could be extorted by even the men in uniform. We've heard about that in Nigeria before. So by far, the safest way to do it is to go to a borrowed exchange in Lagos, Kaduna, Port Harcourt, Abuja, you know, Enugu, and then have your money and change it, you know. And then when you've changed your money, how can you save it? It's very, very easy. You open a domiciliary account. Now, it's going to flash up on the screen how you can open a domiciliary account in GT Bank. But you're not limited to GT Bank. You can open it in Zenith Bank. You can open it in other banks. But I happen to like GT Bank because I've had one in GT Bank for a very long time, and it's very, very secure. And they give you a dollar ATM that you can use in Nigeria and out of Nigeria. You can put it in an ATM. It's going to spit out dollars for you. You know, if you travel to America, you can get dollars. Even in the United Kingdom, in London, in England, they have ATMs at the airport that can actually kick you out dollars, you know. And then it's free, you know, because I've tried it before and I was shocked. It's free. So, you know, you can open a domiciliary account. It's very easy. Look at the steps on the screen. I'm going to leave it on the screen for a very long time. So you look at the steps. It's easy peasy lemon squeezy. They told me not to say easy peasy Japanese. My name is Renan Mokri. If you've watched this and you have questions arising from this, not questions that are irrelevant, you know, a lot of people, they send me questions. Oh, Pastor Renan, we love your jacket. Hey, listen, I can't help you there. But if you have questions arising from what you've watched, put them in the comment section. Or you can go to my verified social media profiles and you can ask your questions there. You can see that blue tick, the blue check mark to know that it's me, because there are several social media profiles in my name that were opened by my fans, people who read my books. They are not necessarily scammers. They're just communities around me. And, you know, I mean, just allow them. Finally, I do not have a WhatsApp forum. I do not have a Telegram channel. I do not have a Gmail email address. All those people who come up and say, you know, they are all scammers. They download my photos because they've seen that my videos tend to go viral. And they've duped a number of people, a whole lot of people. My name is Ronald Makri again. Thank you for watching and God bless you.